of salmon is quite diverse. So some populations are doing well, some aren't doing so well. That's all against the backdrop of climate change, which we're pretty sure will adversely affect salmon across the board. But we still don't know beyond broad strokes, in many cases, what is driving the particular patterns of decline, or for healthy populations, not decline, that really make the whole system tick. The Salmon Health Program does a couple things scientifically. We monitor what infectious agents, what pathogens are infecting salmon. And then using similar technology, we also look at what environmental stressors are affecting salmon. So that could be hot water, that could be salinity stress, that could be a number of other things that we look for. And then at the same time, we are paying close attention to impacts that salmon farming may be having on wild salmon in BC. And one of the pieces there is to monitor what's going on farms. So to use the tools that we've helped develop that are at our disposal now to keep tabs on the farms themselves, what is infecting farm fish and how that could be spreading to wild salmon.
While we were conducting the research for the Salmon Health Initiative, my lab was also developing a new technology, one that we now call Salmon Fit Chips. And this was envisioned as a new tool that would allow us to understand cumulative stressors, not just infective stress, but how affected are salmon by changes to their environment, both due to climate change, but also due to other anthropogenic stressors. We have sets of biomarkers that are predictive of, for example, thermal stress. We find that thermal stress in sockeye salmon can be affecting 80% of fish in the Strait of Georgia. This new tool, it can identify really specifically where fish are dying.
We've also been able to show that infections with some of those diseases are impacting salmon survival. And that's really key. So we've been able to make the link between salmon farms, disease on farms, transmission to wild fish, and then depression in survival rates of those fish.
Through my lifetime, and even now, I do commercial testing, sockeye and chum every summer in that catch and release, and it's just been going down and down and down and down, and to where in the last 3 years now, this will be the fourth if we don't get food fish. And that's huge for our people. Right now our salmon's in jeopardy of being extinct in these rivers, and the time's now to do what we can for the future.
I really hope that in the short term, we can help hold the government of Canada to their commitment to transition away from open net pen salmon farming. Over the longer term, I hope that the tools that we bring to the table can help to ensure the health and productivity of wild salmon throughout BC and beyond.